what? You're not allowed to own it anyway. I'm not taking your gun away. You need 100 rounds and you're...
No,
I did not say that. That's not true. I did not say that. It's a viral video like the other ones you're putting out that are simply a lie. Wait. Take the AR, your AR-14s. That's right. Your AR-15s are legal.
Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. I am with Jerry Wayne. He is the man that took on Joe Biden at that auto plant in Detroit. It took place in March, but he was able to say to Joe Biden what many of us would have loved to say, but he had the opportunity. He did it. He represented well. Jerry, thanks for coming on
Pleasure.
The channel. Glad to have you. I know these guys want to hear more of what you had to say, but let me start out by asking, did you know Biden was going to come in? Let's take back up a little bit and find, you know, what exactly happened.
Yeah, I had no idea that Biden was going to be coming in that day. They told us like the very first start of the day that he was going to be coming in, and I had about 2 to 3 hours to actually figure out a question I wanted to ask, but I didn't know there was going to be a questionnaire, so I just wanted to show up prepared in any way possible.
But when you watched the video, there were a lot of people around. How did you get front and center to challenge him on his 2A proposals or narrative?
It's actually funny you asked that. I had a first year apprentice working with me. He's about 6'3", and I told him, I was like, hey, make sure you get to the front, get me to the front so I can ask a question. He's a big 2A guy as well. And he's like, yeah, no problem, boss, and just made sure I got to the front right there. And lo and behold, actually, the media was right next to us too, so it kind of all worked out.
It worked out well, and what I liked was your aggressiveness. Now here you have a guy who's a presidential candidate, and he was going, I think, into a friendly Democratic environment expecting to have a great photo shoot and all these people saying how great he is. And here you are challenging him, and he lied.
Yeah.
He lied. He said that he did not say he was going to take away our guns. He said you were full of crap, not those words, but something else.
Yeah.
And then you continued to press him on. Were you shocked at the way he treated you when you challenged him?
Was I shocked? Yeah, I was a little bit brought back at first, but at that point I was ready for anything. This man's trying to take advantage of our Constitution and actually overturn our constitutional rights. So I'm ready for absolutely anything. I'm not about to back down no matter what he was going to say. Now, he could have very respectfully said, hey, you know, we're not taking questions, and I would have respectfully walked away. But he didn't do that, and he actually wanted to come on me and start to bully me. But when he starts to bully me, I'm there representing the average American, average working American throughout the United States, and we don't get pushed back, and I think that I showed him that.
Yeah, you are that, and that's who you're representing. That's who's watching right now. These are pro 2A guys. They're people just like you and me.
My kind of guys, huh?
Yeah, they're great. They're great. And they would have loved to have the opportunity that you had, and you represented so well. But he started stepping up in your face, pointing his finger at you, he even said to you, do you want to take it outside?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, and he also has a quote, too. It says, like, you can't have any guns, and you can't have any weapons. You know, I'm paraphrasing, but you guys look at the video itself, and that's what he says, you know. So he's stumbling all over his words. He's going back and forth. He can say what he wants to say and what he actually means. And it's very combative, but lo and behold, this is the man that's running for political office, and he wants to come and take our constitutional rights. We need to be able to step up and actually ask this man questions. But yet, now he's playing whack-a-mole around the country right now, saying, I'm going to be here, I'm going to be here, and not letting people actually come to his stuff. So we can actually ask questions. He doesn't care about the American people.
Right, and he certainly doesn't care about our Second Amendment rights. He's made that clear. This has been going on for years with this guy. And he says, go buy a shotgun.
Yeah.
But when it comes to your rifle, he said, you need 30 rounds to hunt. That question was never even brought up.
Right.
You were talking about, you know, taking away the guns, which he said and then lied about it.
That's right.
And so you were, that ticked you off a little bit.
Well, yeah, he says this thing like you need 100 rounds to go hunt a deer, right? Well, you know what? That's besides the point, because it's not about going to hunt a deer. It's not about home protection. It's not about defending yourself when you're out in the mall or whatever. It's about overthrowing a tyrannical government. And that's why he doesn't seem to see what's actually happening here. We want these firearms because of Joe Biden.
Yes. Yes. And the narrative, the people that he is trying to serve is not us.
Correct.
It's the far left people who don't like our guns and don't want people like
and China.
You and me to have. And yeah. That was good. All right. So you had this. I noticed that a lot of other people, when you were, guys were going back and forth, they're like, he answered the question, and you just kept going forward at them, and they were trying to get him out of there, but Joe kept coming at you.
Right. Well, that's just it. Like, I was definitely in a pit of people that were not and on my side.
Right.
I'd probably say 99% of the people that were not, definitely not on my side. And you know what? I don't blame them for that, though, because Joe Biden comes in here and he's taking this demographic and he wants to come in and pander and say, hey, how you guys doing? Come vote for me. See you later until next election.
Yeah.
Right. Well, that's not the way we're looking at it. You know, these men are working 8, 10, 12 hours a day, like 5, 6, 7 days a week. And we don't have time. A lot of us don't have time to go home and read up on politics. We want to go home, kiss our kids goodnight, put food on the table, and go on from there, you know? But he comes in here and said, hey, you saw me on CNN for 5 minutes. Well, that's what you believe in now, right? But we now have these technological devices that we can actually figure out the stuff on our own. And then when he wanted to combat me on that, and all the guys around me started to combat me on that as well, I know the truth. I actually sought this out for myself and did my own due diligence. And that's what I hope everybody else starts to do as well.
Yeah, well, I saw it immediately, and I liked the way that you didn't back down. And for that case, Joe didn't back down either, but he lied. And then he called it an AR-14.
Right. Well, when I ended up, and towards the end, I asked him, like, why are you advocating for these so-called assault weapons when people are dying by handguns? You know, if you really care about people dying, and I wouldn't say that, I don't want to take any guns away at all, but wouldn't you start with the most problematic gun? Doesn't seem to be the case. He wants to take out the most accurate gun and the most popular gun. Why? I think that we can see it now. The guy wants to overturn the Constitution of the United States.
Yeah, yeah, right. All right, well, hey, I really appreciate you coming on. You did a great job. You represented me. You represented all these people and so many millions others. And you are on social media.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. YouTube is coming soon. And it's all at Jerry Wayne AR-14, not 15, AR-14, and that's with a J. So if you guys want to come out and help this push against tyranny, I'm doing everything I can. A lot of big things coming up as well, guys. I got my own organization coming up too. I can't talk about the name on it of it so far, but really big stuff that we have going on. So come on out and follow me, be a part of this, Jerry Wayne AR-14, guys.
And your life has really taken off after this in a...
Yeah, it's taken off. It's been a whirlwind. It's been absolutely crazy. I just spoke with Donald Trump Jr. the other day. I spoke with Eric Trump as well. And we definitely have a lot of things that are moving now. And things are definitely looking me up. And hopefully I will be able to help this, help the country out with actually bringing up to fruition of what's actually happening here and actually protect the Constitution.
All right. Well, listen, I'm here for you.
Appreciate it.
If you need help with that in any which way, I'm right here for you. And we've got a lot of people here.
Yeah,
they would back you 100%.
Yeah.
All right.
I hear you guys are the best.
They are. They're great. Yeah. Thanks, Jerry. Keep up the good work.
You got it.
I appreciate you watching. And you guys be safe.